This tutorial is sponsored by Acvis, who creates amazing software that you can plug into Photoshop or use as standalone programs. Their Sketch software lets you create a fantastic wide variety of awesome realistic pencil drawings that you can customize. In addition to their artistic tools, they have 24 incredible image editing programs that'll simply blow your mind. Try Acvis Sketch for free for 10 days by clicking the link below in my video's description and use the exclusive Blue Lightning TV discount code to receive 10% off for the permanent license key. Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to make someone or something appear from thick, billowy smoke. Open a photo that you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. I provided the smoke brush set that I'm using. Its link is in my video's description below or project files. I also provided the link to the website where I downloaded it. Once you download the brush set, open your brush tool and brush picker. Click the gear icon and click Import Brushes. This will open your list of brush presets in your brush folder. Click Free Smoke Photoshop Brushes 1 and click Load. Scroll to the bottom of the brush panel to see the brush set you loaded. Open the folder and scroll down to see all of the smoke brushes that you could use. Now that you have the brushes, the next step is to separate our subject from its background by making a selection around the subject. For this example, I'll use the Quick Selection tool. If you're using this tool as well, drag it inside the subject to select it. To remove selections outside the subject, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag over those areas. To check your selection, press Q on your keyboard to see it as a quick mask. Revert it back into a selection by pressing Q again. To refine its edges, go to Select. If you're using a version earlier than CC 2015.5, click Refine Edge. If you're using a later version, click Select and Mask. If you prefer to use Refine Edge instead of Select and Mask, Shift-click Select and Mask. I did in-depth tutorials on both of these filters, so if you'd like to watch them, I provided their links as well. Check Smart Radius and drag the radius to the right a bit. To make your brush bigger or smaller, make sure your Caps Lock key is off and press the right or left bracket key on your keyboard. Brush over soft or feathery areas like hair. Output it to a new layer. We want to make a new layer below the active layer. To do this, Ctrl-click or Command-click the New Layer icon. We'll fill the empty layer with black, but first, check your foreground and background colors. If they're not black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Since black is our foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Make a new layer above it by clicking the New Layer icon. Name it Smoke. Invert your foreground and background colors by pressing X on your keyboard so white is your foreground color. Open your brush tool and brush picker. Scroll to the smoke brushes. In this set, there are 15 from which to choose. I encourage you to try each one to see which will look best on your image. For this example, I'll choose number 15. As you can see, this particular brush is 4,565 pixels in size. Once you pick your brush, press Enter or Return. To adjust its size, press the right or left bracket key to make it bigger or smaller. I'll increase its size to the max, which for this brush is 5,000 pixels. Then, I'll click on my document to see the smoke. If it's not positioned exactly where you'd like, undo the last step by pressing Ctrl or Command Z and try again. Next, we'll blend the smoke into our subject, but before we do, double-click the subject layer to make it active and to open its layer style window. In the Blend If section, there are two slider bars. This layer affects the layer we currently have selected in the Layers panel, which in our case is the subject, while the underlying layer is our smoke layer. Basically, Blend If uses luminosity to blend layers together. We want the lighter pixels of the smoke to gradually be revealed through our subject, so we'll use the underlying layer to do this. Dragging the left slider will cause the darkest pixels of the smoke to punch holes through our subject, and dragging the right slider makes the lightest pixels of the smoke do the same for the lightest pixels. The more we drag across the slider, the more pixels punch through. To create a smooth transition of revealing the smoke through our subject, go to the triangular shape slider icon on the lightest pixels of the underlying layer and Alt-click or Option-click the middle of it. This splits the icon in two. Drag the left half of the icon to the left. You'll notice that the further we drag it, the more of the smoke's lightest pixels will show through our subject. If you're using version CS6 or later, we'll colorize our image by clicking the adjustment layer icon and clicking Color Lookup. Open Load 3D LUT and feel free to click on each one to see how it looks with your image. I'll click latesunset.3dl. If you'd like to make the color less intense, just reduce its opacity. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.